First of all, I'd like to thank you for watching. This is 7 minutes on the Sabbath day. And this is my seventh video. The number seven is the most important number. It's all about numbers. In every religion, in Freemasonry, in the Essenes, it's all about the number seven. 7 days in the week. The Sabbath day is the seventh day. Seven husbands in the Bible. Seven candlesticks. Everything revolves around the number seven. So this video is going to be a little bit more, I wouldn't say aggressive, but I would say a little bit more to the point. I told you I was going to talk to y'all about a little bit about finances and lending money and stuff like that. About who's lending us all this money that we seem to have to keep borrowing and going more and more in debt through interest rates. First of all, most people say America owns it. Well, if America owns money and they're lending it to themselves and ruining their country through interest debt, wow, what a country we got. If we already got all this money, why do we lend it to ourselves? Because we don't have all this money. All this money has been kept in Switzerland for very many years. That's why all the wars that have happened, Switzerland never gets a bomb dropped on them. Because the people in Switzerland that have all this money are lending money to both sides of each war. So it's a win-win situation. You're not going to bomb a country that's lending you money to build bombs and weapons to fight your enemy. That's a no-go. So that's basically how it works. And as far as who owns it, all you have to do is get on your smartphone and punch in what banks in the world don't the Rothschilds own. I've had many people do it, and they're amazed. It says every bank in the world but Iran, North Korea, and Cuba. China got a central Rothschild bank. Russia, central Rothschild bank. Everybody's got a Rothschild bank. And as I told you before, I'm not against anyone. I'm not anti-Semitic. I'm not anti-gay. I'm not anti-black. I'm not anti-anyone. I believe anyone should be able to do what they want to do. A saying I really love is, all that matters is what you do with the time you've been given. If you want to waste this time, that's your prerogative. But I always, when I read all these religious books, the Quran, the Bible, the Book of Mormon, I see things in there that just, like the Bible, what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? And when you find out how short 80 or 90 years is, and you, most of you aren't even coherent up to that age. You're gone at 60, 65. You're just walking along babbling. You have no clue. You're on so many medications, drinking so much alcohol, that all you just stumble back and forth. No way you know what in the world is going on. But, and the Rothschilds are Jewish. Rothschild, Baron von Rothschild, is the one that formed the State of Israel in 1948. All you got to do is look this stuff up. So what karma? The most beautiful example of karma. You reap what you have sown. Since the beginning, the Jews could not own anything. They were kept in ghettos. They were treated like scum. They couldn't own anything. And now, they own the world. They own Hollywood. They own New York. They own the Federal Reserve. They own your world. And every day you get up and go to work and take a third of your money out of your pocket and you pay your income tax, it goes for one thing, to pay the interest on the debt. It never pays the principal. I think y'all know about finances, what the principal is. Well, it doesn't pay it. So it's just basically given to one family, the Rothschilds. Everybody in the world. It's beyond bizarre, but I don't think it's beyond bizarre because this man's a genius. I mean, a genius. I basically bow to him. I mean, how he does this. And nobody seems to know. But all I want him to do is stand up and say, yeah, I own it. I mean, like I told you in one of my other videos, if I owned it, I'd be glad to tell you, look, I own it. This is the way it is. You can't change it. So just keep doing what you're doing. I mean, if you hide and you keep secrets, They're afraid of something. But like I said, somebody has to own it. And what better people to own it than them? Because they have been treated terrible. And now, look at what we got. That's the greatest example of karma that I've ever seen. And now I want to take you a little bit to the other side. We're going to talk again about Enlil and Enki. Because this is very big. I know you people don't want to believe it, but these things were written down. They were baked in clay tablets. They never went away. Basically, what's going on here is for thousands and thousands of years, these beings live way longer than we do. There has been a war going on for control of this planet by these two half-brothers for thousands of years. That's why nobody gets along. Everybody wants what everybody else has got. Because they, one of them serves Enlil's line, one of them serves Enki's line. They have sons, they have descendants. That's the way it is. And we have to understand that these things are going to make an appearance sooner or later and let us know what's going on. Now, before I go tonight, I want to tell you a little bit about Freemasonry, which I think Freemasonry is not a bad thing. As with everything, you use it to get knowledge or you use it to make money. And I've talked to many Freemasons. That's what the 33rd degree is, the 33rd vertebrae in your back. 33 degrees of consciousness, how to elevate your consciousness. Leslie Wilmhurst in the 1920s talked about positive energy and reincarnation and regeneration of the spirit. Things that people talk about now that everybody thinks they're, you know, new age or whatever, but this is real stuff. Energy is what it's all about, elevating your consciousness, like I told you before. All of the old Freemasons, Manly Hall, they all talk about this, that we walked with the gods. The gods walked with us. That's exactly right. Gods, extraterrestrial. That's what it is. There is the great architect of the universe, as the Freemasons say. But as they believe, they are deists. George Washington was a deist. If you look up what the word deist means, they believe that God, the supreme being, does not intervene in human affairs. We're basically just ruining everything ourselves through greed, pride, envy, ego, lust, gluttony, everything. We ruin ourselves, we ruin the world through seven deadly sins and about elevating your consciousness, starting to give up things that keep you from rising to the top. And something's going to happen when these people on a lower frequency, something very unbelievable is going to happen, and they're just going to basically be gone because the frequency is going to change. And if you're at that low frequency, it's not going to match the frequency that we're going to, which is called the fifth dimension. What's going to happen? I feel sorry for you because that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to raise your level of consciousness. I want you to read these books. Just look at what I'm telling you and find out for yourself. I will not tell you anything that's not true. I mean, I don't care what you think of me, like I said before, but try to elevate your consciousness. I want to thank you for listening, and I'm going to talk more about Freemasonry and the Royal Secret. When you're 32nd degree, you're called a Sublime Prince of the Royal Secret. And the Royal Secret is that Baphomet runs this show, the Goat of Mendes, Pan. And like I said, I don't care what anybody bows to. I just want people to know who they're bowing to. Just like on the radio station where I live, it talks about raise your index finger and your little finger and clench your fist and jab your fist in the air. When you do that, Baphomet's loving you because that's Baphomet's horns. I believe Richard Ramirez, the Night Stalker, did that too, didn't he? And said, Hail Satan. As with everything, just like Lucifer and Satan, two distinct things. You can be a Luciferian and not be evil. But if you're a Satanist, you go the other way, yin and yang. Like the Indians say about what's inside of you, there are two wolves in you. And the little boy asked the witch doctor, well, which one wins? He said, the one you feed. Well, they're not wolves. There's a jinn in you that's basically a dualist. He's in you. And the way you act and what you feed him creates what he becomes. Case closed. You fertilize something with evil, filth, what does it become? Evil and filth. You fertilize something with purity, love, and compassion, what does it become? It becomes light, or either you become dark. Like Star Wars, they knew exactly what was happening. The dark or the light. But let me tell you one thing. The light will win in the end. So think you may be serving the dark and you don't care, but when the light comes shining, you're going to see what happens to the dark. Not good, like I told you before. So turn into light beings and not dark beings. It's your choice. Do it. Thank you very much.